Tialisimu. I'm the founder and inventor of the Bionic Boot. It's a form of urban transportation which allows a human to move around the city with high mobility and a great speed. The Bionic Boot is pivoted and has a tension spring itself, which stores energy with each stride. And as you push off, it recoils like a catapult and gives you a longer stride length, giving you increased speed and mobility. The initial inspiration came at age 12 from watching a TV program on kangaroos and the way they store energy in their long Achilles tendons. I wanted to see if I could replicate that in a mechanical device to allow a human to run faster. I did the initial first sketch right there. I made the first prototype at age 18 to see if the mechanics and the principles actually worked. I was actually able to run for the first time with bungee cords and old rollerblade boots. That gave me the inspiration to make different prototypes. I've been working on it for many years after that, developing and evolving different designs, not only mechanically sound, but also aesthetically pleasing to what we see here today. The current prototype is working well. I'm running up to 25 miles an hour. I want to try and progress to ostrich speed between 40 and 45 miles an hour by utilizing electric servos and probably have a power pack supply. So with each stride, I get a little bit of a boost and also increase my speed. I work 6 days a week in busy nightclubs and restaurants to pay for all this. I've done all the work myself, two hands and very limited capabilities in terms of tooling. I do all the construction, the drill and angle grinder and a hacksaw. Being a maker to me means you have an idea and then you take it to the next stage, drawing, designing to a prototype and then making something that works to actually help people or the world at large. I'm trying to bring the Bionic Boot to the masses so everyone can have the feeling of getting bionic. Up, it's a super fast man with bionic legs. Welcome back to our Best of the Internet Speed Freaks. We've seen some outrageous rides and startling science, but it's time for a giant leap into the future of running. This is San Franciscan inventor Kiahi Seymour and his red bionic boots, running at speeds no human has run before.
These boots look like science fiction, but they actually work. Using these boots, this guy can run at 25 miles per hour. That's 40 kilometers an hour. The actual world record, though, for human running is 28 miles an hour. That's 45 kilometers per hour, set by Usain Bolt.
The difference is, Usain Bolt can only keep up that speed for a short period of time.
Whereas using the bionic boots, this guy can run at 25 miles per hour consistently.
We went to San Francisco to try to catch up with Kiahi. Hey, slow down.
Wearing the boots is quite exhilarating because as you stand up, not only are you a foot taller, but also as you start to run, you feel like an increase in your stride length due to your longer length of your leg, giving the feeling of a superhuman or animal. So it's something definitely everyone should try at least once.
So how do Kiahi's bionic boots help him run faster?
Kiahi has been inspired by nature, and in particular, he's taken his inspiration from the fastest animal on two legs, the ostrich. Ostriches are extremely fast runners. They can get up to 37 miles an hour, which is 60 kilometers an hour. The thing that makes the ostrich so efficient when it's running is that they run on their tiptoes, and between their toes and their midfoot, they've got these very, very strong tendons which act like a spring. So when they put their foot down, they store energy up, which is then released as they take off.
He's mimicked this with seven springs in the bionic boot. So just as the boot contacts the ground, these seven springs are extended, storing that energy, and then just as his weight's coming off of it, they release all that energy, literally giving him a little more spring in his step.
The hardest part about wearing the bionic boots is standing still on one spot. Walking and running is quite natural, but the difficulty and expertise comes in running at high speed and be able to control that. Recently, I took these boots to New York. New Yorkers are not afraid of making comments, and I had some nice ones along the road. Everything from robot legs to a kid shouting, "You are the future." So I thought that was a nice comment.
Oh, episode of the $6 Million Man aired. Now, with all that modern technology has to offer, how close are we to that $6 million promise?
On your left!
I guess I'm about to find out.
This strangely shod Demibot is Kiahi Seymour, creator of the aptly named Bionic Boots. Better chase him down.
Sorry, I'm late. I have just like normal feet. So boring. These are sick.
Ever since I've been a child, I just want to make a human run faster. So I look towards fast land animals. Initially, I got that first inspiration from how kangaroos were storing energy in their Achilles tendons. Then I look towards a fast bipedal animal, the ostrich. So they run up to 45 miles an hour. So then I research the horse, cheetah, and see how I can make a mechanical device you'd strap to a human leg to make them run faster. Usain Bolt tops out at about 27.4 miles an hour. At a fleeting moment in the 100 meter sprint, I want to try and keep that sprinting speed for a prolonged period.
Kiahi has been evolving his bionic boots for years, with the key elements being tough rubber springs to mimic animal Achilles tendons, with a spring-loaded toe, and mountain bike tire for grip.
So I'm always trying to like hone the weight of the boots down, and this is the current prototype we have here, all fiberglass exoskeleton shell with aircraft grade aluminium. My idea for the future is actually trying to add some sort of actuator to give a little bit of a boost to each year's stride. I'm rocking at about like 10 to 12 to 15 feet. I want to increase it to about a stride length of 25 foot. That's the same as an ostrich. I'll be rolling at about 45 miles an hour.
That's crazy!
And it's closing in on Steve Austin's 60 miles per hour.
You're actually planning to take this to market.
Absolutely. I got to get everyone to feel the sensation of being bionic. It's pretty spectacular just when you put the boots on.
Kiahi assures me that they're easy to use.
I feel like I wish I was, you know, like 12.
Guess I'll just have to take his word for it.
All right, so let's talk about the criteria. They're not available quite yet, but they're getting really close. I mean, these prototypes are almost ready for market. The price point on them is going to be around what a bicycle would cost. And finally, how close are we to the $6 million man? Well, we're not at 60 miles an hour yet, but we're getting really close.
Boot came around when I was 12 years old, watching a natural history program on kangaroos. I look at their mechanical principles in terms of leverage and elastic energy storage to make a human run faster. The current Bionic Boot X17 prototype uses the latest lightweight materials, for example, aircraft-grade aluminium, carbon fiber, and titanium. So a normal human walks at around 4 miles an hour, jogs about 8. Marathon runners run at about 14, 15 miles an hour. I can reach up to 20, 25 miles an hour. I'm trying to push the capabilities further, possibly to 40, 45 miles an hour with some bionic advancements. The bionic boots are a huge technological advance compared to the caveman shoes of the sneakers we see here today.
Brooklyn, New York. Four wannabe household brands and their makers are here in search of a life-changing investment from Mark. But to get an offer, they must impress him every step of the way. Starting with the pitch.
Whoa! What?
Yeah!
Dude, you look like a superhero.
How you doing?
Gentlemen, I present to you the Bionic Boot. This device allows a regular human being to be able to run at speeds of up to 20, 25 miles an hour.
I'm liking these already.
From the age of 12, basically, I've been inspired by the fastest land animals on Earth, and I've been wanting to run like an animal. Once you put them on, feel like a superhero. I invested all money in myself, working 6 days a week as a bartender, 40 hours a week.
Bionic bootmaker Kiahi Seymour became obsessed with crafting a device to help humans run at high speeds, above to 25 miles an hour. Using animal anatomy for inspiration could be brilliant, only if he gets it right.
Bionic boots.
These bad boys can make us run 20 to 25 miles an hour.
Absolutely.
They're just so cool looking. Carbon fiber, red, chrome. But let's see if we can break them down here. I would much rather just go try them, but we're going to talk about them.
I just wanted to illustrate where the stretch is.
Absolutely. See, this acts like an animal's artificial foot here, pivoted to give you purchase on the ground on uneven terrain, and also gives you lateral mobility as you corner and turn. So the pivot here mimics the toe, and they have small little rubber springs mimicking the tendon of the animal's foot.
It's the number of springs right here on the back. So you're saying if we want a softer stride, maybe we take off a set, and we only run four, or if we really want them stiff, we can add on
absolutely
eight. Fast land animals like the cheetah have a spring-like spine and tendons that enable it to achieve longer stride lengths. The Bionic Boot uses the same concept in the main lever, which provides a majority of the propulsive force by stretching the spring as the user lands, and then springing them forward like a catapult when they contract. With the levers raising the user onto their toes, the boots lengthen their legs and stride, which increases their overall speed and efficiency.
The only problem is we're sitting here talking about them instead of out running in them.
Awesome.
I am so pumped to try these boots on, and the idea of being able to run faster than you've ever run before, I'm ready.
Yeah, he's all geared up here. Why don't you get him in those boots?
Let's do this.
I told you I have two left feet, right?
It's kind of a weird feeling to have people strap you into something.
Oh, now we're talking.
Okay,
now I'm all geared up.
So why don't we get up and have a good, get the feel of it first. You just need a few minutes just to practice this. Always concentrate on your foot placements and also not catching the back pieces. You really need to concentrate.
I need to be careful.
Absolutely.
Right now, he's moving around pretty slow and he's stretching the spring, but not very much. As he starts running, does he start increasing that potential energy?
Absolutely. So the more speed involved, the more mass is imparted to the spring itself. The more force you impart on the lever and the boot itself, the longer the springs get, and hence more power is derived into the boot.
He's making you nervous.
Yeah, he's doing a great job, though.
So what am I doing? Are you getting in your gear?
I will get my gear right now.
Okay.
There you go.
Yeah, feels
and natural. You want me to shout at you?
All right, try to keep up. Right as I say, try to keep up. Try to come up.
Remember, concentrate. Let's go for a little run.
Let's start.
We're just going to be jumping. Okay, no. Always concentrate on your feet. It's really tricky. That's when you catch them. So on the way back, yeah, just bounce along. There you go.
You ready?
Okay,
we'll keep up with you. You do what you need to,
yeah,
okay?
I'm just going to run. I'm just going. Thanks, mate.
Be safe.
Got it.
That's 10. 15. That's 20!
Woo!
Dude!
You got it!
How does it feel?
Woo!
Dude!
Yes!
Awesome.
You saying I'm coming for you!
Dude, I saw 20 on the speedometer.
Nice!
In the record books, the fastest human could sprint almost 28 miles an hour for a very short period of time. Kiyagi got up to 20 miles per hour, and it looked like he could have even gotten faster.